Imagine for a moment if someone told you that your job as a parent is to make sure that your child behaves indifferently to everything under all conditions, and that he's always predictable. Your child does exactly what you want when you want it under any conditions for the rest of his life. It sounds great in theory, and it sounds like the dream child, but I challenge you to actually be able to pull that off. It would be impossible for you to really make your child a robot and to do everything you wanted and behave neutral under any conditions. The reason you can't do that is because your child is an individual in the same way that your dog is an individual. And so in this video, I'm gonna be asking you to really change your perspective of your dog. I know it's going to ask you to step out of your comfort zone, but I'm gonna propose to you that you really cannot make your dog be neutral in any condition under any circumstance. I'm going to propose to you that there are things that are out of your power, and that is okay. So if you're interested in having a little bit of a mindset shift, keep watching. What's up, guys? I'm Jenna with Dog Liaison, and on this channel, we break down scientific research in order to inform us on how to train dogs. Today, we're talking about the myth of getting your dog to behave neutral under all conditions. This is something that gets proposed a lot from other trainers, that your job as the dog owner is to get your dog to behave and listen to you and obey you for safety reasons under all conditions. What I'd like to propose to you today is that that is an impossible feat. That having another trainer imply that that is your goal is actually unethical. What I propose to you today is that having the goal of getting your dog to be neutral and indifferent to all stimuli is not only impossible, but it really strips your dog of their autonomy. That goal is basically saying that you don't want your dog to have his own opinions, that you don't want your dog to have his own perception of the world. And to do that to another individual is not only unethical, but it's dangerous, because you are inevitably going to get behavior outcomes that rebel against that. From an evolutionary perspective, species, especially species like mammals, are going to want to have their own brains. They're going to need autonomy. They're going to have their own opinions of things. They're going to create their own associations, and they're always going to put their own safety ahead of your desires, no matter what. That is what evolution is meant to do, is to prioritize their safety and their fittest. Additionally, creating neutral associations is not up to you. You don't get to decide how your dog feels about something. Your dog decides that. Your dog decides whether or not he likes something, doesn't like something, feels safe, doesn't feel safe, wants to interact with it, doesn't want to interact with it. Your dog gets to decide that. And the idea that you get to decide it for him, again, is an impossible feat. Your dog has his own brain, my friend. Now, there are things that we can do to influence our dog's opinions. There are strategies up our sleeves to make sure that we are influencing our dog's opinions towards things the way that we want them to be. And even if that means that you are creating a very indifferent opinion, you have strategies to influence that. Now, the idea that we want our dog to behave neutrally is really grounded in the idea that we want our dog to be well behaved. We don't want our dog lunging. We don't want our dog barking. We don't want our dog being a nuisance. We don't want our dog causing a scene. And so really what we were saying when we say we want a neutral dog is that we want a dog who's not going to display his emotions externally outlandishly. And the flaw in that logic is that it implies that just because the dog is sitting, or just because the dog is in a down, or just because the dog isn't barking, that directly means that the dog is happy and content and living his best life. But those two things are not true. What you see on the outside is not always an indication of what's happening on the inside. For example, you're watching this video, you've seen me smile, you've seen me talk to you, you would perceive that I'm happy and I'm content and I'm just talking to my camera. But you would have no idea how I actually feel. Perhaps I just lost someone and I'm actually in depression. Perhaps something really amazing happened in my life and I'm experiencing something really exciting and happy. You wouldn't know that, because what I'm putting on my external face is different than what's happening internally. And this isn't necessarily just true for humans, it's true for all species. It's true that dogs are not going to necessarily be able to fake and to lie, but they do know how to suppress emotions. They do know how to suppress behaviors and behave a certain way in order to avoid punishment. And more often than not, people have used obedience. They have used their sit, their stay, their heel. They have used those skills to suppress the dog's emotions. And then they say, look, he's behaving neutrally. But that doesn't actually mean that the association in that dog's mind is neutral. And this is what we see when we talk about a dog who's, look at him, we see him on TikTok and he's behaving so neutrally. What I see is suppressed emotion. And it's very important that you recognize looking for neutrality and looking for indifference and looking for the obedient dog, while understandable, is not achievable. But I want to get to the root of why we have this goal. Why we have this goal in society to have the neutral dog, to have the perfectly flawless dog under any conditions will obey us whenever we want. The root of that is in control. We want to have control over what happens to us and the outcomes that we can predict. If we know that our dog is going to behave a certain way, then we have control over what's going to happen to us. We want to control what's predictable. That is the root of this desire. And it's okay, there's nothing wrong with that. That's basic human psychology. It's perfectly fine that you crave that control. That's normal. But you also need to recognize that your craving that control is exactly what your dog craves for himself. Your dog also craves that need to control what happens to him, his body, and the future. He wants to be able to orchestrate. This is an essential need for all individuals, for most species. So I know this was a bit of a mindset shift. I would love to hear in the comments what thoughts come up for you right now and what nuggets of gold have you taken away? Any aha moments? Tell me in the chat below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button, consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell so you get notified when I drop a new video, and I'll see you guys next week.